being in consulting, one of the awesome things about it is actually getting to go out onto client sites. You know, you're not just stuck at a desk all day. You actually get to sort of go out around town and explore sort of new industries, new areas. But the particular thing I enjoy about it is that as sort of a junior, you're not just stuck in a dark room pressing the green button on a photocopier, but you're actually working really closely with senior members of the firm, sort of trying to help these clients do their business better. I was sort of nervous going in just because you get told what it's going to be like, but there is a certain element of not really knowing until you get in there. So one thing that really surprised me was the fact that we were doing this real work. You know, I kind of presumed that, yeah, I'd be given things to do, I'd be proofreading, I'd be, you know, looking over people's work, but I was really given that responsibility and accountability from the start, and I kind of didn't expect the wheels to start turning so quickly. At 9 a.m. yesterday, I was actually having a coffee with a director on the small project I'd been, and we'd just been in a really interesting interview. And we're both sort of super excited and probably not ready to go back to the office yet, so we sort of pulled into a quick cubby hole on the way back and kind of went over what we'd heard and tried to compare it with what we'd heard before and sort of try and reconcile that and see if we could come up with some really interesting insights. Recently, I was part of a big project for a public sector client, and the first thing that we did was kick off with this two-day workshop, which involved about 50 or 60 people from the client. Now, previous to this, I'd done workshops before and helped facilitate them, always with a close, watchful eye by either a director or a partner. But this time, I had about 15 to 20 people to look after all on my own, and it was just an awesome experience, you know, a real chance to sort of push myself and actually see myself learn on the job. The awesome thing about what I do is that there really isn't such thing as a regular day, and I know that sounds like a cop-out answer, but coming into this, what I was looking for was variety, and you know, to always have something different going on, to really be pushing myself in a bunch of different areas. So, I mean, to take yesterday for example, get in, you know, you check through your emails, I'm always behind on those things, but then have a small team meeting to talk about our plan for the week, where we're going to go. Then I had a couple of interviews at, you know, one client, then ran across town and helped facilitate a workshop, you know, at a different client, solving a different problem. So having to sort of get my mind in sort of different areas throughout the course of the day is about usual for this job. Yeah, one of the awesome things about PwC is both the formal and kind of the informal opportunities that it gives you. So you see messages coming out with, you know, get involved in this, whether it's something, you know, sporting or cultural or sort of fundraising for a community. But I've recently joined the International Associates Network as one of the sort of country communication leads. And so that was something that was sort of offered to me internally, and I sort of said yes before I thought about what was really involved. But you do get those opportunities to sort of broaden your horizons and connect with people from overseas. It's the kind of thing that's, you know, offered on a regular basis. Some of the key skills that are really important for our job is being able to learn quickly, being keen to kind of put yourself into some different situations, being mentally agile and able to adapt quickly. And the kind of the great thing about those skills is that they come in all shapes and sizes. You know, I work with a bunch of different people from a bunch of different backgrounds, you know, but we all have this ability to sort of really push ourselves and be able to adapt, which is, you know, an awesome thing about working here. The culture at PwC is actually what brought me to PwC. Like any, you know, young, diligent person, I was looking around and doing my research, and obviously I wanted to work in a place that was going to give me some fantastic opportunities and really challenge myself and give me great opportunities. But it was also the fun and the vibrancy of the place that I got a sense of when talking to everyone here. And when I came in here, that's exactly what it was. We work hard, and I wouldn't say it's playing hard, but it's ensuring we have fun and that, you know, we find the time to relax while we're doing this. The culture at PwC is actually what brought me to PwC. You know, like any diligent young man, I was sort of busy doing my research and talking to a whole lot of people, and you find out that, you know, PwC of course had that professionalism and it had sort of unparalleled opportunities, but I was really drawn to the culture, and I actually explored that in my interviewing with people and what it was. And what I think it is that, you know, we work really hard and there's absolutely expectations placed on you, but there's also a real desire to make sure people are enjoying themselves at work. You know, whether that is you know, formal events like, you know, back to base at the end of the month, or whether it's the ball, or whether it's being part of the PwC indoor soccer team. It's a really lively, fun, vibrant attitude. I think it's the fact that you're getting training and experience and exposure to senior clients that I don't know if I would get anywhere else. Equally, at my age, overseas experiences are something that is really attractive for me, and the idea that I can go on secondment with the company, you know, keep building while, whether it's Amsterdam, whether it's London, whether it's New York, I mean, fantastic opportunity. The biggest piece of advice I'd give a potential new grad or new hire is to make sure you keep your horizons broad and, you know, really follow your passions outside of school, whether that's sporting, cultural, or with the community. When you walk in the door at a client, they assume you've got the brains and they assume you've got the grades, but they want to see you, you know, as a whole person, someone they can really relate to. And, you know, I've had plenty of conversations and build rapport with clients that have had nothing to do, you know, with what I did at school.